All right, if you've watched the video about the gas laws, that's where we're picking it up from that discussion. We're looking at the combined gas law, which relates pressure, volume, moles, and temperature, the four variables of a gas, to each other if something changes. And we have the combined gas law, which is P1 V1 over N1 T1 equals P2 V2 over N2 T2. Now there are eight variables here, eight different variables that stand for eight different numbers, but it's not as complicated as that because you will always be asked a question that needs this in the form of something has changed. So if something changes, if one of the variables changes, then you're probably looking at needing this equation. And you're going to be given the numerical information for all of the variables except for one, and you need to solve for the one. So let's look at an example problem. This is a problem I have asked on a test before. It may be kind of small, but here we go. There are a lot of words here. Please don't let word problems put you off. They aren't too bad. Read through the word problem once, get sort of a gist of it, a feel for it, and then when you go back through the second time to read it, you want to focus in on the numbers and the units that are given. So here we go. A balloon filled with helium has a volume of 1.25 liters at sea level, where the atmospheric pressure is 762 millimeters of mercury and the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. What will be the volume of the balloon in the mountains, where the atmospheric pressure is 637 millimeters of mercury and the temperature stays constant? So we've got something changing. Notice that the atmospheric pressure is changing. I missed it. The atmospheric pressure is changing, and so we have variables. We've got a lot of numbers. Let's go find our numbers and focus in on them. All right. And we also are told that something stays constant. Now, occasionally, when you work a problem like this, you do have constants. In other words, if the temperature stays constant, that means T1 and T2 are exactly the same numerical value. And in fact, we know what they are. They're both 25 degrees Celsius. Now, we can't plug into this equation with degrees Celsius. We have to be in degrees Kelvin to work these problems because we have to be in the absolute temperature scale. But in this particular case, we don't need to plug in any value for temperature because mathematically they will cancel with each other. So in other words, our formula now reduces down to P1 V1 over N1 equals P2 V2 over N2. You might also notice that nowhere in this word problem does it talk about the moles of gas, N. And again, this is a common way to ask the question because our balloon, this is a balloon, it's tied off somehow with helium. Our balloon never opens, it never loses helium, it never gets extra helium. The assumption is in this problem is that the helium balloon stays closed the entire time, which means that my number of moles also stays constant. So, and in this case, it doesn't tell us how many moles, but mathematically, we don't need to know how many moles because these two numerical values will cancel. So the bottom line, it's even easier than that, P1 V1 equals P2 V2. So we've already reduced this problem down to only needing the variables of pressure and volume because those are the only things that are canceling. And you would go through a similar process with a different word problem. You would cancel any variables that stay constant because the numerical value for the one condition and the two condition are exactly the same, and mathematically that means they cancel. What I find it useful to do in this particular type of problem is to make a little chart. I'll make a little chart of pressure, volume, temperature, and number of moles. I'll go ahead and add all four of them, and I'll look at condition number one and condition number two, and I'll, as I read through the problem, I'll pull out numerical values. So the helium balloon is filled with to a volume of 1.25 liters, and that means my V1 is 1.25 liters. It is probably useful to go ahead and write units in this table. The atmospheric pressure is 762 millimeters of mercury. That's my starting condition. So I'll write 762. Again, it's useful to squeeze in the units there. The temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. I do know that as I work these mathematically, I have to have my temperature in Kelvin, so I could go ahead and convert that, but we already talked about the fact that it's going to end up canceling anyway, but I'll go ahead and stick it in there. What will be the volume? There is our question word. What will be the volume? So V2 is the one we're looking for, where the atmospheric pressure is 637 millimeters of mercury, so P2 is 637 millimeters of mercury, and the temperature stays constant, so I'm going to be 25 degrees Celsius. My number of moles is constant. These guys end up canceling, and there are my pressure and volume units. So all I have left to do is to rearrange my equation and plug in my values. If we come back here and look at my starting point, I'm solving for V2. To solve for V2, I need to take the P2 and divide both sides by P2. And so I'll have this. I like to rearrange it before I plug my numbers in. That's me. I think it makes more sense, and I'm less likely to make a mistake that way. My P1 is 762 millimeters of mercury. My V1, I'm sorry, that was my P1. Did I say that right? It's my P1. My V1 is 1.25 liters, and my P2 is 637 millimeters of mercury. And all I have left to do is to plug those values into my calculator and see what the answer is. All right, I'm going to take 762 times 1.25 divided by 637, and then my calculator spits out a string of numbers, 1.49529... If I look at my sig figs, it looks like I need 3 sig figs. Yes, you have to do significant figures for the rest of your life. And so let's come this direction, and we'll say my answer is 1.49. If we look at our units, the millimeters of mercury is canceled, and we are left with units of liters. My final answer is 1.49 liters.